Hi friends, welcome to the next video in the LaTeX series. In this video, we will be covering the basics of tables. One might require to add tables in their documents to convey certain specific data. Using the table environment of the LaTeX, it is easy to insert the tables and make the documents more interesting and informative. Let us start by creating a new chapter for tables. The next part is to insert the table environment in the LaTeX document. Start by typing /begin table and press enter to autocomplete the table environment. Add the parameter ht to insert the table at the insertion point in the line of code. Let us try to understand the table environment. The first code inside the environment is /centering. This sets the table at the center of the page. Then there is a tabular environment where one actually adds the data that goes inside the table. The styling of the table is also handled inside this tabular code. The next line of code is /caption, wherein one can add the table name to be displayed. The next line is /label, which helps the author to refer the table anywhere in the document. We can see two parameters CC written beside /begin tabular. To change the number of columns in the table, one needs to change these parameters. The number of letters indicate the number of columns. Suppose we want to add 3 columns in our table. Change the parameters to CCC as shown in the code. This means that the table would contain 3 columns and each column would be centered and separated by a line. The next code is /hline. This adds a horizontal line to the table at the top. /hline is basically used to draw a horizontal line from the cursor's position. Then we add the column headings, namely serial number, column 1 and column 2. The ampersand symbol is a special symbol and it is used to differentiate the column entries. So for these 3 entries, we use 2 ampersand signs. To end the current row and shift the cursor to the next row, use /// Then we use /hline command twice to draw 2 horizontal lines. This will differentiate the column headings from the column entries. Then enter the 3 rows as shown in the code. Differentiate the columns using ampersand sign and go to the next row using /lines. Change the caption to first table and label to tab first table. Then compile the code. On compiling, we observe a table which is created below the chapter titled tables. Let us add /hline after every column entry and check the results. Compile the code and we can see a horizontal line has been added after every row in the table. Now try changing the parameters of /begin tabular to L, C and R. Compile the code once more and one can observe that the first column gets left indented, middle column is centered and right column is right indented. As the text occupies the whole of the right column, it is difficult to observe. However, if you change the data in the right column to have text of varying lengths, one would observe the indentation properly. The letter L in the parameter stands for left indentation, C for centered and R for right indentation. Let us remove the lines separating the parameters and observe the output. We observe that the vertical lines separating the columns has disappeared. In the similar fashion, we can remove the external vertical lines of the table if required by making changes in the parameter of /begin tabular field. The size of the table looks small in the document. To increase the overall size, we can scale the document using scale box command. This command is inserted before /begin tabular code and must encapsulate the whole tabular environment. The scaling size must also be passed as an attribute. In our case, we would scale the table to twice its size by writing 2 in the scale box command. On compiling, we can notice the difference in the previous table and the newly compiled one. That's it for the current video. In the next video, let's discuss different table styles and how to achieve them. Hit the like button and share the video with your friends. Until next time, stay calm and keep learning. Peace out.